Hello friends, in this video, we will try to understand the next part of the data compression, which is known as the popular method among all the methods in the data compression is run length encoding method. So first of all, the question arises, why RLA? Though we are having the lossy and lossless both kind of methods in our hand, like a sliding window technique, dictionary based window technique, for example LZ77, LZ78 and LZW, then also why we are going for RLA? The answer is, it is advantageous in two ways. The first main advantage is, it is the simplest method of the data compression. That means for LZ77, LZ78, LZW and so on, whatever time and the steps, complicated steps, that means the drawing of table and all that things, we required. Comparatively, in RLE, we don't require to do all these things. The steps to do the RLE encoding and decoding are very simple as compared to the other method steps. So it is a simplest method of the data compression. This is the first main advantage of this RLE. That means it requires less time to encode the data. It requires less efforts and simple form. So this is the simplest method. And the second thing is, it is the lossless method of data compression. Lossless and lossy, there is a difference between these two terms. In the lossless method, whatever the input we try to provide to our encoder, that complete input we can achieve at the output side. So X input, if I am going to provide to the input side, then after decoding that data, I am again getting the X output. So there is no any loss of the data. That means no loss of the data occurs, and hence always the lossless methods are more useful for the data compression. And so that the first thing is that it is a lossless method, so we will of course go for RLE, but not only for RLE. If we are only taking the advantage as a lossless method, then we are having what? LZW, LZ77 and all that methods in our hand. But then also, why RLE? Because it is simplest method. Why simplest? Because it requires less time, less effort, and it is simple method for the calculation to encode as well as to decode the data. Now we will see why the name is RLE, that is run length encoding. So what is this RLE? It saves the data in its value and count format. This particular algorithm will try to save the data, but what kind of input it has? It has the input of sequence of multiple symbols. So sequence of multiple symbols or multiple characters are always we can found in each and every algorithm. But here, the most probably similar sequence of multiple symbols it has in its particular string, and then we have to save the string or save the data which is in string in its value and count format. And this similar sequence of multiple symbols can be, we can treat them as a running sequence, and hence only it is known as run length encoding. That is nothing but what? RLE. Now, it is more beneficial when the data is in sequence or series. For example, I will first explain you few examples. For example, the given string is, this is AAAA, BB, CCCCCC and DDD. That means what? How many bits are in this particular string? That means in the given string, 15 bits are there, 15 characters are there. And now using this run length encoding, why run length? Because see, it is a running sequence of the similar characters or symbols, but the symbols are multiple also. That means A is there, B is there, C is there, as well as D is present in the given string. Now, if I want to write down its array format, then what I can do? Write down its value and its count. So the first character is what? A. So this is nothing but value. And how many times A appears in your this given string? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times. So this 4 is nothing but what? Count. So it is very simple to convert any format into the array format. Now the next thing is that the next character is what? B. So B is nothing but the value, data value. And how many times count it has in this string? 1, 2. So 2 will be the count. Next one is C. So C is nothing but what? Value of the data. How many times C repeats? 6 times. So C6 is nothing but the compressed form of the data in the array format. And finally is D. So D appears 3 times. So D is the value and 3 is the count. So if you are going to observe now this particular output, then how many bits or how many character it try to store? That means indirectly space. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So instead of using space 15, now we achieve the compressed size. Try to understand, if I want to decode this data, then what I can do? A4, B2, C6 and D3. Simply I will write down the value first A. How many times it appears? 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. After that B. How many times it appears? 2. 1, 2. C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After that D. So as it is, whatever the input present in the given string, that complete input I will get or I can achieve as it is at the output side. That is nothing but what? Receiver side. And if I want to send this particular string, what I can send instead of using such kind of huge space, what I can do? I can send A4, B2, C6, D3. So here I try to compress the size of the data, but here I am not going to lose any value in the data. So this is known as the lossless data compression method. So you are getting success to as it is forward or transmit a string at the receiver side using the data compression. And why it become possible? Because of RLE. So within a minute we can encode the data as well as we can decode the data. So that it is very simple method of the data compression among all the methods. Now, I already told you RLE means similar sequence of multiple symbols. Here, if you are going to use only one symbol, then what will happen? Suppose I am going to write down the data like A, B, C, D. Again, the multiple symbols, first of all, we will take, and its RLE format. A is nothing but what? Value. And 1 is what? Count of that particular value in the string. So how many times A appears in the given string? Only 1. So A, 1. B, 1. C appears only 1 time. D appears again only 1 time. How much bits you required here to save the characters? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. And how much you required here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That means sometimes in one case, RLE is not more beneficial or it is worst in this particular case. Why? Because if you are going to convert a given string, which is not a sequence, if it is not a sequence of the symbol, then you may achieve the increment in the size instead of compression in the size. So in that particular case where the sequence is not present, then that will be less beneficial, or you can say this is the highest drawback of RLE. So the next point is multiple symbols. Why multiple symbols? Because whatever the number of data, if it is huge, then RLE will be more beneficial. So though the multiple symbols are not there, here we can modify it, single or multiple. Because if A appears thrice, then I can write down what? A, 3. So here how much bit I required? 3. Here how much bits I required? 2. So again it is beneficial for me. So though the symbol is single or multiple, then also it is more beneficial. But most probably array we used for the huge amount of string where it contains a number of data. And this is the drawback of array where the sequence is not present. So it saves the data in its value and count format, no doubt. But it is more beneficial when the data is in sequence or series. This is the proof of our this particular statement. So in this way, this is the first example which you can use to convert the characters into the array format. So like that, we will go for the second example. So the next example for array is given words are cup, cup. I try to write down this particular word 4 times. So if you are going to observe, this space also going to count when you will count the size. So cup and plus 1 size. So that is nothing but 3 into 4, 12, 13, 14, 15. Again, it will take 15 size to store this particular words. And array format is cup and how many times the data is what? Cup. How many times count is nothing but what? 4. It appears in the string 4. So that will take only 4 sides to send the data, to store the data. So again you are able to achieve the good compression while transmitting the data. But similarly, when the words are different or appears only one times, then cup, it appears one time. Again, the space after the words, bus, it appears one time, and t, it appears one time. So it's array format. Here you are able to write down this particular given string in the 3 into 3, 9, 10, 11. So 11 size will require to store this string. And array output is what? Cup cup, it appears once. Bus bus, it appears once. Tat, it appears once. That means what? 3, 3, 3 and 1, 2, 3, 12. So size is going to increase after the array output when the sequence is not present. No doubt here multiple symbols are present, then also it is okay. But if the sequence is present, then array is able to compress the data size. And so that sequence is important in terms of characters, which we have seen in the previous example, in terms of words also. Now, the next example is binary value. So we are also able to convert the binary values into the array output. So how we can do it? There is a string of a sequence of the binary number. Binary means representation in 0 and 1. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. This is the given string. How we can write down into the array format? 0, it appears. This is the data value, 0. But as the format is binary, what? How to represent it? In a bracket, comma. How many times that appears? 3 times. Again, 1. How many times that appears? 6 times. Separate it with the help of comma. Then 0, 3 and 1, 2. So it is very easy to transmit this particular data instead of transmitting a huge string. Because while transmitting this data, the manual errors will be minimized. While there is a chances of the manual error while writing down this data again and again. So this will be more useful as it is in the compressed form. But the binary value, when the given binary values are not in the sequence, then what will happen? 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. In the sequence of the string, again, you cannot calculate the 0 where if you are going to calculate like this, 0, it appears 1, 2, 3. No, it's not good. You have to calculate the sequence of the data in the series itself. So 0. 0 appears once. After that, whether 0 appears? Yes, but not in series. So, draw another column. So, 1. 1 appears how much time? Only once. again after this one, where one appears? Yes, it appears, but there is a zero present in between these two one. So you must have to again draw a bracket for this zero. So zero, it appears how much time? One. Again, one appears how much time? One. So if you are going to observe this, obviously here the size required to store the data is less, but here the size required to store the data is high. That means when the binary values are also not in sequence, then RLA is not useful. So always, whatever format you are going to take, that should be in the given sequence. Otherwise, it will be the worst case to transmit data by transmitting your given format into RLA. So, this is the best example of the binary value. Similarly, I have already told you, if you are going to use this bus, then the RLA format will be bus 2. So, how to decode this format? Write down the value. How much time it appears? Write down it. So this is nothing but decoding. So after encoding the data, you are getting this. After decoding the data, you are getting this. But what will happen while decoding the binary values? That kind of questions are always asked in your example. So we will try to take that particular example to solve for RLA encoding. So this is nothing but the example. The given words are 00000, 11100, 111111, 000, 110011. This is a huge number of string. That means the number of data in string are more. But whenever we are going to convert it into RLA, that will look more simple. So try to convert it into RLA output. So RLA format is what? Value and count. So what is the value? Value is 0. First 0 appears. How much times is appears? 5 times. So 0, 5. After that 1 appears. 1 appears 3 times. 0 appears 2 times. Again 1 appears 5 times. 0 appears 3 times. Again 1 appears 2 times. 0 appears 2 times. And last one is again 1 appears 2 times. So this is nothing but RLA output. So now we have to go and decode the data. That means by using this particular input, we required a string or the words. So actually here we can say given numbers are. So now you have to give the sequence. A sequence for this every bracket. So like that, this is nothing but number 8. So 8 brackets we have used to write down the combination in terms of value and count in the RLA format. So the highest value of the sequence number is what? It is 8. Now the next step is log of this highest value to the base 2. Find out that answer. Now here you are getting the highest value 8. So log of 8. If not 8, in other examples you may or may not get 8. So what is the equation or what is the formula? Log of the highest value which you are getting with the help of this count of the sequence. That you have to write down and find out the answer for that particular highest value to the base 2. So now I am getting here highest sequence 8. So log of 8 to the base 2 is nothing but convert it into log base 2 10. Why? Because our calculator is familiar with log 10. So log 8 divided by log 2. This is nothing but base 10 answer. So simply you can put up in your calci log 8 by log 2 and you will get the answer 3. So now it means 3-bit representation is required to write down this count, not a value, to write down the count. So count you can encode with the help of this 3-bit representation. And already the values are in the binary format. Why? Because the given numbers are in binary format. So here also the values, every value is already in binary format, but count is not in binary format. So it is our duty to convert the count in binary format. But how? with the help of how much bit that we have to find, and that we can achieve with the help of the highest sequence number. Take the highest sequence number log to the base 2, find out the answer for the count value, and that answer will be the representation of the bits which we required to convert it into the binary. So now we will try to do it. So for the first column, that is nothing but what, 0, 5. So 0 write down as it is. After that, 5 convert into the 3-bit representation of the binary. So what will be the value? 1, 0, 1. After that, 1, 3. This is nothing but what? 1, 3. So 1 as it is, 3. 3's conversion in binary. 0, 1, 1. After that, 0, 2. So 0, now, what is the binary conversion of 2 into the 3-bit? That is 0, 1, 0. After that, 1, 5. 1, 1, 0, 1. Similarly, for 0, 3, 0, 0, 1, 1. For 1, 2, 1, 0, 1, 0. For 0, 2, 0, 0, 1, 0. And finally, for 1, 2, this is nothing but what? Value and its count. So 1, 0, 1, 0. This is now the conversion of count into the binary. Already the value is in the binary form, and now you are getting success to convert the given count is in binary form. So the final answer after RLE encoded data is what? Remove this comma, remove the bracket, and write down this value. So this is nothing but what? The final answer after encoding. So this is the encoded data. Again, you are able to decode it, and again you are able to achieve the given string. So in this way, you are able to do the RLE encoding. This is nothing but the encoding, not decoding. After decoding the data, again you will get what? The previous string as it is. So RLE output and RLE encoded output, these are two completely different things. So RLE output means compressed format representation, and RLE encoded data means again you require to convert that format into the given example format. As the given example is in binary format, you have to again encode this complete data into the binary format, and this is nothing but what? Encoded output. So RLE encoding part is always frequently asked in your exam, and this is the generated output with the help of that. Now, the applications of RLE, where the RLE we can use. So such kind of example in terms of binary, in terms of words, in terms of characters, in terms of symbol, we have seen how to convert that into the RLE, and it is more beneficial, no doubt. But where exactly that particular encoded or decoded output is going to use? The first one is, these were employed in the transmission of analog television signals. We all know that our signals and their values are continuous and in the sequence, series of sequence. So while writing down the one exact value along with the count for a particular signal or the generated multiple signal, we can easily use the RLE. The second is, RLE is particularly well suited for bitmap images such as computer icons, and was a popular image compression method for online services. Image, whatever the image size will be there, that is in the form of pixels. So to crop the image or to convert the size of the image from high to low size, we can use the RLE, because many times the number of pixels store in the image are same. That means for image, whatever the pixels we have required, that number of the pixels at every matrix, that may be same or they may be continuous. So such kind of case happen in the image compression. So instead of write down a huge matrix, instead of drawing a huge matrix again and again for the image, we can do one thing. We can write down that particular value, and we can write down that particular value with respect to their count. So in the image compression, this particular RLE is more popular. So these are the two main applications of RLE. Instead of that, we can use it for the lossless compression. Whatever the applications of the lossless compression are there, they are again the applications for RLE. So in this way, we can elaborate the RLE, we can understand the RLE, we can prove all the rules and the definition of RLE with all these examples. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda.